We'll bring in Republican Michigan Congressman, member of the House Financial Services Committee, Bill Huizenga. Good to see you, sir. From Grand Rapids, where the rivers converge. Ben Tracy over at CBS News reporting that the president is expected to announce gun control legislation this week, but the substance of it is a mystery. What would you be willing to support?
As you indicated, that the substance is a mystery. We don't know what's in it. In fact, I had a conversation with a member of law enforcement this morning at church, and we were talking a little bit about this, and it was interesting hearing my colleague talk about being in favor of an assault weapon ban, but not in favor of a buyback, and that seemed to be incongruent. But even this police officer friend of mine was saying, look, who's gonna go and enforce this if that's the direction?
That's
very different than a red flag.
I've yet to hear any Republicans go ahead and say they're to support any of Mr. O'Rourke's proposals. But you didn't answer the question of what you would support out of the White House. If you could have the president submit something to Congress that would be meaningful and hopefully protect Americans, what would that bill look like?
Well, so I'm not sure anybody has exactly that answer as of yet. For me, as I'm looking at it, I want to see how we are going to deal with the mental health side of that. How are we going to continue to empower friends and family and school administrators?
There was already a bill that came out of the House, sponsored by Democrats, that added mental health to background checks, and a lot of Republicans opposed it, and it doesn't look like it's going to go to the Senate. Is that something that is worth supporting?
Well, we had previously done that with 21st Century Cures, actually. There had been a number of those things. So what we saw was, again, a group of issues that some of them were fairly reasonable, others were really overreach. And we're seeing this set of bills that have been talked about to have these elements of overreach that I think are going to go nowhere in the Senate. So it's going to be hard. I think if empowering states to explore red flag laws is something that is
I'll take it as that there's not a list right now that you have ready to be willing to support. We will move on to something that's happening in Michigan. It's a pretty simple question. You either say, here's my proposal, or you say, there's nothing that I want to support. You've had a minute to talk.
Ilhan Omar back in the news for making a pretty sick connection between illegal aliens and the slave trade of old. This is one you are not going to believe, but we have the video. But before we show it to you, please be informed YouTube has removed us from suggested videos and are actively suppressing our reach by surfacing CNN and MSNBC when folks are searching for news on YouTube. So please help us reach new viewers by sharing our reports. Likewise, tap the red subscribe button below to be the first to know when we publish new reports. Thank you. 100% Fed Up reports that Ilhan Omar speaks to the Congressional Black Caucus comparing the slave trade 400 years ago to current camps at our border holding illegal aliens. Now, please note, she mentions the word dungeon several times to describe the African slave camps, and then says that they remind her of our own detention centers. Watch this.
Well, we arrived in Ghana, and one of the first things we did was to visit what some would say is a castle, but they were dungeons. And I remember, as we arrived, one of the guides let us into the female dungeons. And he started giving us a description of what used to take place. And every time he gave a description, I had this sort of flashback
Congressman, we appreciate
to an image that I saw on TV in Libya, where you had The president's Africans first campaign managers in a small on Capitol room Hill preening that were now captives.
Corey Lewandowski in front of the House Judiciary Committee as part of its investigation
today.
Into whether the president should be impeached.
And every time he would talk about the separation of the kids and from their parents and how they would have
is a witness, though,
young girls
the
be in the same dungeons as the women, or they would have young boys be in the same dungeons as the men. I couldn't stop seeing images of the current camps we have here at our borders in the United States.
Very unfair to the president.
Wow, what a stretch.
The president had done nothing wrong.
What
a stretch. And Sessions planned to meet with the special counsel and let him move forward with investigating election meddling for future elections.
What's happening down the borders? People are coming here illegally. They're breaking our laws.
What the president wanted Sessions to do.
Okay, it's not like we're just like rounding these people up. Okay, these people have broken laws.
Lewandowski wouldn't answer questions.
They're coming here voluntarily.
Or anything else that mattered in his
testimony
today. And
they're getting
caught. Instead, for much of the last 3 hours, he's been repeating this refrain.
Mr. Congressman, I'm trying to adhere to the White House's request.
So of a story that happened 400 years ago, I constantly had this reminder, this horrifying image of many of the things that were taking place there in that dungeon, now taking place, whether it is in the shores of North Africa or in the shores of the United States.
I recognize that the privilege is not
okay,
mine,
so,
but I've been asked by the White House to
again, a total stretch. A total stretch. She's reaching big time now. Now, the article points out the same. The one key thing she forgets to mention is that these people came illegally to the United States and are free to go back to wherever they came from at any time. They were not forced to be in detention centers. Most came knowing they would end up in a detention center. Willful ignorance to make America look bad is sedition. This woman hates America, and she hates its people. She's pandering to the Congressional Black Caucus. But this should be offensive
to
the
very public faces of the
Trump. How can
White
she compare the brutal and inhumane slave trade to our detention centers
of
illegals?
Exactly what conduct becoming
there is no
of the
comparison, absolutely no comparison, and she knows it.
Is where we start today with
and this is where they write
with
conflating
the
two
Jake
things
Sherman,
doesn't
senior,
work. It's just
Politico,
not true.
Ron Klain, former chief
We're
of staff to Vice President Joe
Share
Biden,
this report, please,
and
leave your comment below. We'll see you
with
the next report. For the next
News
Network, I'm Gary Frasier. Thanks for watching that report. You know, just a handful of days ago, the tech company Qualcomm made world history, and it looks like this. It's smaller than a penny, yet the hardware you see before you is about to set off a firestorm. You see, this tiny piece of plastic is actually the very first 5G modem of its kind, and it officially sets in motion an investment opportunity that investors have been talking about for the past year. Let me make something very clear. This is
so my next guest was very much front and center and very fired up for the fireworks today as the top Republican, the ranking Republican on the House Judiciary Committee. Congressman Doug Collins joins me now. We should note that we reached out to several Democrats on the Judiciary Committee as well, and they were not able to join us for this segment tonight. We hope that they will in the future. Congressman Collins, thank you very much for being here tonight. I want to play for everybody a little bit of what you had to say today, because you were definitely fired up, as I said. Watch this.
Get information. That's what real oversight is. A majority made a promise. We'll impeach him. We'll investigate him. For most of them, it happened in November 2016 because they couldn't believe that Donald Trump won.
Mr. Chairman, there's so much that we could actually do together. There's so much. But as long as we don't have time, we'll continue with rerun season.
All right, so that's how you started out today. What was your reaction when all was said and done?
I've termed what has happened today is bring a big donor to work day. Because at the end of the hearing, which we objected to, they allowed a staff member who's a big donor, Barry Burke, $70,000 to the Democratic Party. He got to ask 30 minutes of questions. 30 minutes, and he's a contract employee of that committee. He doesn't have to give up his practice anywhere else. He
happens going forward. As I mentioned at the top of the show, there are a number of avenues of investigation. The president's taxes. There's also a New York investigation that has asked for 8 years of the president's taxes. Where do you see this going next on your committee?
Anything that they can do to get a headline. This is simply the chairman has turned this into a frivolous committee. All